Welcome to the PeopleSoft Campus Solutions PUM Image 29 Highlights. In this video, we will provide an overview to the key features delivered as part of PUM 29. We'll cover enhancements to improve student engagement, including adding more drop zones to fluid pages, delivering more chatbot skills, and other self-service updates. We'll review the latest in global name formatting, and then move to a review of the updates for regulatory regions, starting with the UK. For the US, we'll highlight updates for financial aid, SEVIS, NSC reporting, and an update to veterans tracking. Let's get started with enhancements to student self-service. Drop zones. As your institution looks for ways to remove customizations to simplify the application of maintenance, take a look at where we've added drop zones to pages. Drop zones let users add fields to delivered pages without customizing the delivered component or page definition. Fields are displayed and processed along with the fields from the main page definition and any nested subpages or secondary pages. Continuing from previous releases, drop zones have also been added to the top and bottom areas of the View My Classes and Enrollment Appointment pages. The drop zones in View My Classes can be used to display class schedules and facilitate real-time conflict checking when students search for or want to enroll in classes. Self-service class search. Staying with enhancements to student self-service, on the Fluid Class Search and Enroll page, we've added a subpage that displays class schedules and schedule conflicts in real time. You can configure checking for time conflicts for enrolled, waitlisted, or shopping cart classes against class options that appear. So when students search for classes, they don't have to react to an error condition and go to another page to check for conflicts in their schedule. And as an extra benefit, this subpage could be used on the pages where we've delivered drop zones. Be aware though, that the time conflict functionality is only available on the class search results page. That will not carry over to other pages if this subpage is reused in other drop zones. In addition, this enhancement is fully configurable in setup, so campuses can choose not to activate it if they don't want to use it. Chatbot skills. Our customers are excited about the possibilities they can embrace with the Oracle Digital Assistant platform and the delivered skills from Campus Solutions. These skills are available as part of the PeopleSoft Picasso Library, which contains the skills and related digital assistant content for all the PeopleSoft applications. We've delivered three new skills in PI 29. First, service holds. With this assistant, students can access their current service indicators or holds. This skill only displays negative service indicators and lets students filter service indicators or holds by department or by institution. Student account. With this assistant, students can see their current amount due, total amount due, and other account details. Students can also make a payment directly from the digital assistant interface. And finally, the third assistant uses a third-party integration with Google Maps to see where classrooms are located. Students can access directions as well as see a street view of the building where their classroom is. This skill leverages the setup on the Campus Solutions building table, where institutions can enter longitude and latitude information to identify the location of a building. And of course, your students can access these skills from various devices, their smartphones or desktops, laptops, or tablets. Be sure to check out the Campus Solutions YouTube channel for a video feature overview of the new chatbot skills. Another couple of updates for student self-service enhancements involve the fluid apply for graduation flow. First, we've incorporated the common attribute framework functionality into the additional information step in the activity guide. We modified the page to include a region that will expose any common attributes enabled for the apply for graduation record context. Administrative users can view or edit this CAF data using the updated additional information page in the application for graduation component. You'll now be able to collect and manage data that's unique to your institution as part of the apply for graduation process with no customizations. Next, we've enhanced the step that lets students select which name to use for graduation purposes. The updates we've delivered for name type controls and format are included in this page of the activity guide. This enables students to edit the name types that include the preferred name type values and which have been identified as type control of edit preferred fields. This is a good lead-in to our next set of enhancements, global name formatting. Providing popular flexibility to our customers, another feature which has received attention over the last few PUMs is providing more control for how names are used in campus solutions. In PI 28, we adopted the global name formatting structures, which had been introduced by the PeopleSoft HCM team. Those provided extensive configurability for labels, sequencing, is a field required or not, and so on the classic style sheet pages. For example, you can now update the label for all three preferred name values to a label that is appropriate for your audience. For example, live name or chosen name. The PI 29 update contains those same configuration options now applied to existing fluid pages where you can manage names. Some of the changes you'll want to evaluate include, we've added the preferred middle and preferred last name to accompany the preferred first name and the associated configurability options. With this structure, you can have a single row for the primary name type with the preferred fields enabled. If you've chosen to include the preferred name values on any of the name types, such as the primary name type, you can now enable the user to edit just the preferred name values, first, middle, or last. You'll see a new translate value called Edit Preferred Fields on the Type Control page to enable this control. In PI 28, we expanded the options on the Name Format Type page for how the display name, the formal name, and the PeopleSoft format name are configured. As a result of these new configuration options, we updated the Fluid Personal Details page to use display name to display preferred fields, which typically aren't included in the formal name. Also, we've updated the autocomplete attributes for the preferred last and preferred middle names in PI 29. Let's review the UCAS updates for the UK. PI 29 delivers a number of updates that support the 2024 UCAS regulatory cycle and apply cycle. These include an update to the import reference data process to import delayed confirmation reasons, updates to the decision entry pages, transaction processing, and import application data to support returning the reason and action as part of a delayed confirmation decision, a new mapping for gender to map the UCAS codes to the gender values used in core person records, updates to the import application data process to include new HESA fields added for 2023 cycle applicants. And for the 2024 apply cycle, we've added updates for the service operation for applicants' rejection to use reject by code, modified the rejection reason setup to add rejection label, modified the apply decision page and the apply decision export process to allow code rejection decisions, and modified pages to remove the deprecated reference field. Moving to the UK HESA updates, PI 29 includes multiple updates for entities and fields to support the UK Data Futures Return, specification version 1.5.1. Here's a summarized list of the updates for the ITT and Unistat's 2023-24 returns, and more detail can be found in the documentation. US financial aid, including COD, federal methodology, and direct lending updates. Let's start with general COD updates. We've delivered the ability to benefit related code changes for aid year 23-24. The changes include new translate values for the student eligibility code 15 and ATB test code 13. We modified and added new message catalog entries, made application package people code changes, as well as modifications to ATB and validation COBOL programs. We delivered regulatory updates for Pell Grant for CODA year 23-24. This project includes modifications to fields, records, SQL, file layout, and people code. As part of the 22-23 COD updates, these new fields were implemented for Pell Grants: payment period start date, payment period end date, and incarcerated student indicator. We have updated the Pell Grant reports so that new fields appear in the Pell Grant year-to-date and Pell Grant electronic state of account reports. Moving to direct lending, for the bug number shown here, we modified the SQL script to shuffle the compare records so that cost of attendance isn't reset to zero during the origination and outbound processes for direct loans. We delivered objects for regulatory updates for the direct lending COD, the direct loan school account statement for aid year 23-24. This includes the field length changes for gross amount, net amount, and other fields as per the 23-24 layout. Finally, updates for federal methodology. To resolve the bug shown on the slide, we modified the FM parent entity properties to account for data retrieval tool flags in the request message that's sent to our needs analysis Java calculator. We also wanted to make sure that our customers were kept current on the Campus Solutions plans to support the Consolidated Appropriations Act from the Department of Ed. We want you to be aware that there is a doc ID in MyOracle support, which we update frequently to keep you aware of our planned deliverables. This doc ID includes information on the changes being delivered for the next phases of the FAFSA Simplification Act implementation, including SAI. Also wanted to make you aware that the HUGS Financial Aid Advisory Group consults with development on the interpretation and design of the new capabilities, and then they communicate out their findings and their knowledge to the financial aid community. So we hope with both sources of information, you'll be able to feel informed and stay informed on what we're doing in Campus Solutions to support this significant update to financial aid. U.S. SEVIS updates, Student and Exchange Visitor Program. For SEVIS support in the U.S., PI 29 includes updates to the Employment Authorizations page for Curricular Practical Training, CPT, and Optional Practical Training, OPT. The remarks field is now employment remarks for both CPT and OPT. Student remarks are now included in CPT employment add alert events, and the existing remarks tag is updated to employment remarks in the XML. We made updates to the additional data and history detail F/M pages for label changes to the remarks field. Finally, we updated the SEVIS extract process to reflect the employment remarks and student remarks information. Reporting. Adding to the update in PI 28, the PI 29 change for consolidated statistics provides the ability to override the settings at the institutional level for the enrollment status effective date, return from leave of absence, and the NSC 5-point matching options for students with multiple plans on SIP code keys, all located on the Consolidated Statistics page. This allows users to select different processing options for different student populations based on the statistics period for a particular run. For example, the law career could specify summer and intersession terms as those for which they term activate the students, but the students aren't required to enroll. With these settings, the process would skip any stats period for a summer or intersession term where the students didn't enroll and not treat it as a break in enrollment. Veterans benefits. As a reaction to an Ideas Lab entry, we added a checkbox to enable you to track Space Force as one of the military branch options on the Veterans Benefits Summary page. Let me wrap up by including a list of useful resources for Campus Solutions customers. My Oracle support is certainly the primary site for official information. The PeopleSoft information portal is my go-to site for almost anything I need related to Campus Solutions. For interacting with Oracle and your peers, the Oracle community site is ideal and supports the Ideas Lab site where all enhancement requests are logged and voted upon. If you're a HUG member, then you know the value of that community and its extensive file libraries. Finally, if you're working with a cloud product like Student Financial Planning, you'll want to bookmark Cloud Customer Connection. Thank you for listening to the Campus Solutions Pi 29 Highlights, and we hope you will join us again.